Today's patio chat is being brought to you locally by Westridge Furniture in Delphus. See it all at your finer outdoor furniture store.
Welcome back, Everyone. Sergeant Justin Powell's back with us from the Highway Patrol here in Lima. Boy, it's nice to have you back. It's been a while, hasn't it?
Well, it's been a little while, yes,
been
sir.
Been a little while? Okay. Yes, let's talk school bus safety. I tell you, we see them every day. And I wonder sometimes if it takes us a little while to get back into the routine. Is that part of it, you think?
That is. I mean, school buses, you know, for 3 months every year, they're not out there. And
sure.
And then when they come back, we have to remind everybody what they need to do to make sure we keep our kids safe.
Are there certain violations you see, or is it centered around mostly people are just in a big hurry and not paying attention?
Not paying attention is a problem. We actually had somebody pass a school bus one time, and they were on their phone. They said they didn't saw the bus.
That's crazy.
So people need to pay attention to what's going on around them.
I feel like the system that the schools have come up with and the transportation departments and the bus drivers themselves really works if we all behave ourselves as motorists, because you see the kids get out and they wait and they get a motion across that. They're really working at it to try and make it work, aren't they?
Well, the school bus drivers definitely are doing their very best to take care of our kids. It's also up to the motorists to pay attention. So if you see a school bus slowing down or stopping, just stop behind it. On your two-lane roads, you do have to stop in both directions. On your four lanes, just the two lanes in the same direction.
Yeah, I'm glad you told us the rules, too. The other thing I think about is, I was joking with somebody the other day, I see them coming down my road outside Spencerville, and if I see one, they've just dropped somebody off, and they turn the lights off, they're coming. I'm like, I know they're going to turn them on again soon. Is that kind of a thing? Be ready just in case something goes down?
Well, it's very likely. I mean, at every house, there may be a kid living there. And then some people seem to get frustrated when they're stuck behind a bus and, like, they're looking for an opportunity to pass it.
Right.
Just slow down. Take your time. These are our kids we're talking about, and we want to do everything we can to make sure it's safe. Also want to say, you are required to stop 10 feet behind the bus in either direction.
You know, I was actually surprised it's only 10 feet. That seems like it's so close, doesn't it?
But just give the kids room to safely cross the road.
Yeah, get across the road. Okay, you guys as Highway Patrol troopers, I know this is kind of especially a focus right now for you. Do you follow these? Do you keep a closer eye this month? What do you guys do then?
Well, we always want to bring attention during this month, so we want to be out during the School Bus Safety Month so everybody will see us and as a reminder. But most of the school buses do have video cameras on them now. So anytime someone does pass a stop school bus, we're probably going to get a video of you passing it with your face and your license plate, and they're going to come knocking on your door and issue a citation.
Yeah.
This is something we actually have zero tolerance for. Keeping kids safe on their way to and from school is a priority for the Highway Patrol.
Well, and you've talked about this before, too. Obviously, there's a penalty. There's a financial penalty. They could lose some money. But I'm telling you, it's one of those things you've chatted about where, heaven forbid you hit a kid or there's a tragedy, that's something that obviously stays with their family the entire life and yours simply because you didn't take 5 seconds to slow down.
A traffic citation is the very least that will happen. So $165 is the smallest thing that's going to happen to you as a result of passing a stop school bus.
Yeah.
If you hit a kid, that's a life-changing event for their family, your family. And kids aren't necessarily the best at waiting and checking for traffic.
Yeah.
It really is our responsibility as motorists to make sure that we are doing what we're supposed to do.
Are there still ride-alongs with troopers? Is that still a thing? I think years and years ago when I was a kid, occasionally we would have a trooper on the bus just kind of spotting things, especially in areas where they've had problems.
Oh, we do occasionally put troopers on a bus. Mostly we want to make contact with those kids and let them know, hey, we're here to help you guys. And especially we've had some routes where we get continuous calls.
Sure.
In this one area, we're having an ongoing problem with people, like, not stopping when they're supposed to. So then we put a trooper on the bus and really get eyes as to what's going on that particular bus route.
Help solve that problem. All right, slow down, and everybody give yourself more time. Thank you, Sergeant. We appreciate it. It's good seeing you.
Thanks, sir.
Dogaway Medical News coming up next on Noon Edition.